Alrighty. Let's do this. Night number 12 in Gran Turismo 3 A-Spec. Tonight we start the endurance races. First. Even though it doesn't look like it, I am gonna change the oil. Looks like I need it, but I'm gonna change the oil in my Corvette anyway. I don't care. I'm gonna make it all nice and purdy. We gotta start with a bit of a problem that I realized almost immediately after the end of last show. The keen observer will notice when I go to the game status that suddenly I'm back down to 57%, and that's because some dum-dum, I won't name names, some Yahoo forgot to save the game after the last stream, so arcade mode is now no longer done again, even though we did do it. I have video that shows it. If you're watching this on YouTube, the previous parts of this, the previous two videos, was me doing arcade mode, so that's a bit of a problem. Gonna have to redo that. Don't know if I'll do it on camera or off. Since we're going into the endurance races tonight, we're gonna have time after each one of these, at least some of these early ones, so you know. We're gonna be using our Corvette. What I'm gonna do is buy the super slick tires. And I did already buy the engine upgrade for this. No, I didn't. Okay. Watch. Oh yeah, because it just changed the oil, right. Yeah, I was wondering why 1,032 horsepower? Oh yeah, because I changed the oil. So when you change the oil in the car, you get a performance bonus. Because why the hell not? So yeah. That's kind of fun, but anyway. We'll deal with arcade mode again soon enough. Tonight we start the endurance section. 10 endurance races in this bit. Most of which will only be a one per stream deal. However, I might try to cram Seattle and Super Speedway into one stream, because I think those are both sub-1-hour races. I'm pretty sure Seattle's just under an hour. Seattle will probably be also just under an hour, so... Or actually, well under an hour, so... We should be able to do those two at the same time. But tonight, we're starting with, of course, I guess you could say the Daytona 500 of Gran Turismo Racing, the Grand Valley 300. 60 laps around the Grand Valley Speedway. Absolutely no restrictions on car entry, and if we get the victory, we'll net ourselves a cool 400,000 credits and a new car. One in particular I'm hoping to get from at least one of these endurance races, but we'll see. So let's get down to business. This race should take about an hour and 45 minutes if all plays out well. Who are we up against? We have three Skylines. Two of them rated as GTRs. We have the Denso Start Soup and an NSX. Now, we haven't really done much in terms of qualifying, but I think because these are kind of professional style races, let's qualify. Why the hell not? Let's do a one. This will also give me a quick chance to kind of get idea of how poor the handling is going to be with these super slicks. The hell is that? What kind of emote is that? I could have equipped the mediums for qualifying, couldn't I? Oh well. I see. Video game based on the movie B movie. Okay, well. get you the views, I guess. You know, more power to you. Look at the tire wear characteristics. Just like with the Camaro earlier in this playthrough, the front tires take the brunt, even though this Corvette does have a little bit of oversteer on exit. Oh, car. Good thing this is a warm-up lap, because that... That really didn't do a whole lot of good. Okay. I'm just going to pop one lap off here and see what happens. Of an advantage in the only really the last couple of AI cars are really going to get a good time in because of just where they were dropping the track. 54.2 from that's the NSX. I slowed down way too much there. That was not wise. This game does still look good, especially when you're playing it on an emulator at 4x native, so it's basically. Looks like how it would look if it was being played at proper 1080p base, or close to 1080p. So it looks like the NSX has the pole time, 154.2. We should get that, because they would have been starting a little weird. I might give them another. I'll be nice and let them finish their next laps to see a true idea of who's where in terms of times here. We got a 4-second advantage through sector 3. Oh, but the car does not like that corner. Rear tire's still not up to temp yet. Really should have just put the medium tires on for qualifying. I'll remember that for next time. Oh, boy. We should blow these guys away this lap. 150.6. I'm going to let them finish their lap, though, because they should have better laps this time by. Get a really good idea of kind of who's where here on the pecking order for this race. I'm not really committing to run this lap. It's one in, two are in. Might have him here. I think we got the pole here, boys. On super slicks, no less. Who needs medium tires when you can run a 150 point? Yeah, and none of them beat that time, so. Let's see the official times here. Yeah, we got, wow, all right. Well, pole by 2 seconds over the NSX, the soup in third, and then all three of the GTRs. Pretty much almost mirroring each other. The Calsonic and the Loctite, 1/1000th of a second apart in qualifying. Okay, well, we're 8 seconds better than the Skylines, four and a half better than the Supra, and about two better than the NSX. I think we're in pretty good shape. It's just a question of can I keep myself together for 60 laps here? Let's do it. Green flag is out. Of course, we're under auto drive. Now, all right, there we go. So again, we're on cold tires, so overdrove that. Oh, that's just rude. Okay, come on now. First lap of the race, and the Supra's already getting uber aggressive. Now, on super slicks, my goal is to try to go 15 laps. If I can go 15 laps without pitting, I'll be happy. Because then, basically, it's a three-stop race. 15, 30, 45, and then we're good to the finish. It's really going to depend on what those front tires do. Because the fronts do seem to be wearing faster than the rears do. Now, I could, obviously, buy every compound of tire and... Oh, car! Jeez Louise. Traction control enabled, and I'm still... skidding around like a Japanese drift car. Supra ahead of the NSX, and then the three Skylines look like they're not going to be quite as efficient. Of course, I'm fairly confident that I'm on a much harder compound than the AI are. So I very much expect they'll keep up with me for this first lap or two, but once my tires come up to temperature, is where I should get away. Supra looking for the lead. My fronts are starting to warm up a little bit. I don't know if this does anything, but I'm going to wiggle the car around a bit, trying to get those rears to bite a little bit. So yeah, 158.1 on that first lap. Obviously, some of that was the fact that the rolling start's not quite as fast as the... it's coming through there at speed, but this is where we should start pulling away now. Now my fronts are coming up to temperature. The next lap, my rear tires should come up, so... Once they do... This thing is wheel spinning right up through third gear. That is, quite impressive. Very impressive, actually. Yeah, see, now we're starting to get some grip, so now we're starting to pull away a bit. So the NSX and the Supra are going to be right on top of each other for a while. Then those three Skylines are probably also going to stay pretty close. Now we're starting to just starting to march away now. Which is good, because it really means now I can kind of run a little more conservative pace. I don't have to push hard. I don't have to do anything super duper crazy. Which is good, because that means we can probably go. We should be able to hopefully meet our goal of going 50, on a three-stop race. And we actually beat our qualifying time, 49.4. By 6 seconds at the line over the soup. Try my best to not cut that little flick there. Yeah, you can see now we're just like we're gaining like seconds in every sector, like. I would suspect the AI might well be on either mediums or maybe even softer tires than that if they're already like just disappearing here. If I'm gaining speed and they're losing speed, then it can't be very great. As far as I know, the AI pit strategies here in this game are not great. They'll be in every like 6 to 10 laps, and I'll be like, going twice, 2 to 3 times further than them, basically. On a stint. Because thankfully, it's not until GT4 that we have to worry about fuel mileage as well. Fuel? What's that? My car just powers itself. Take her easy through here, because again, we got a lot of wheel spin in the low gears here. So. Now the rears are up to temp. We're going to put up... Oh, we're going to pick up again. How about a 47.3? Another 2 second pickup. So I'm not really even trying all that hard. 12 seconds at the line. So we're... we're 6 seconds a lap faster on average right now. Actually, no. Three laps complete, so actually, no, we're 4 seconds a lap faster on average. We gained 6 on that last lap. Come on. One of the skylines is starting to break away from the other two. Looks like the NSX has broken away from the Supra. Really, the question is going to be, which one of them is going to pit first? Because whoever pits first is probably finishing last when it's all said and done. Just based on sheer number of pit stops required. Lap four in the books. This will be a little, a little bit slower. I don't care. Again, the whole idea here now that we're kind of, we're easily, if we're running 47s and gaining like 6 seconds a lap, it really doesn't matter. We can just kind of take our time and, like I said, now we just kind of protect our tires. Interval at the line, 17.3 seconds on the NSX. Gained about 5 seconds there, but five and a bit, but I say only 5 seconds. Jeez, we might as well be a Daytona prototype, and they might as well be like the GT class or something, which is ironic because the Corvette team is from like the GT. What was their class designation back in the day? Like GTS or GTR or something like that? Then you had the GT class, which was all the Porsches. All the 919s and everything, or whatever the hell. The 911s, or whatever they were called. Of course, in this case, all of our opponents are GT500 cars. The JGTC out in Japan, but we're driving basically a car that would have been built for endurance racing, so it works out. We will use the Corvette for as many of these endurances that we're qualified for. Which I'm pretty sure it's all of them except for Trial Mountain and Apricot Hill. Trial Mountain, I have to run a stock, non-race model car. And then Apricot Hill, I have to run a Miata for some... a stock Miata because... you know... why the hell not, right? Let's run around Apricot Hill at 110 miles an hour because we want that race to take forever and a day. ...22-second lead at the line. Okay, jeez. Extra power boost from changing the oil. If anything's made this car a lot harder to keep under me. Well, the Corvette, not the Corvettes, the Skylines are, at least those two Skylines in the back are almost a minute behind now, so they're losing a solid 20 seconds a lap. It's hard to believe that a JGTC Skyline is running 2-minute, 8-second laps, but or close to it, but based on the track map, they're pretty damn close to a minute behind. I just kind of grind the wall there through the first part of the S-pin, but whatever. All right, here's my question. See this lane, we're kind of coming to the complete lap six. We're kind of starting to enter the pit window if you're running medium, you know, They're definitely not running softs, I don't think. Softs are super softs, because if they were, they would already be on pit road. But we're kind of now hitting that point on mediums where you'd be kind of having to fight to hold on to it. So if they're either on medium or medium slick, they should be in the next lap or two. I can see the slicks maybe getting to lap 10. They are, in fact, running super slicks. They could be in as late as I am. 28-second lead at the line through six laps. The NSX still out there. The Supra still out there. What about the Skylines? Will any of them break for pit road this lap? Not looking like it. No, they all stay out. Yeah, they're now well over. They're almost a minute. Yeah, those last two are almost a minute behind now in just six laps. So they're losing like eight or... Okay, so they're realistically losing like 8 or 9 seconds a lap. Like, they're running kind of high, 156, 157. The NSX probably running around the 152, 153 mark. Super's probably around a minute 55, so... Man, this thing is on ice on exit, I tell you. Corner, center exit of corners. That was actually a really bad lap. Back down into the 149s now. Again, some of that is me taking it easy and not wanting to abuse my tires. But those fronts are yellow, so I could imagine starting to lose some front grip. And the NSX is in at lap 7. Okay. Super to the lead, 41 seconds back, or to the lead, to P2, although really, the NSX had a big enough gap, it should still be virtual P2, but it comes out of pit road. So it's seven laps of stint, it's going to have to stop eight times? I don't think that's kosher. Already, at lap 8, we're looking at lap 8 is a 7-stop race. Lap 10 drops all the way to a 5-stop. By lap 12, you're down to a 4-stop, and lap 15, you're on a 3-stop. So, I mean, unless the NSX was running the wheels off of it, trying to keep up, but I mean... Realistically, with how much tail wag I'm getting here on corner exit, actually, I'm just noticing my fronts are going orange, which... Lap 9. That's intriguing. But all this rear wheel spin I'm getting, I actually might be able to push the. I can abuse. I kind of. I don't know. I guess it's not going orange. Never mind. Looking at the tire wear indicator. Oh yeah, I guess not. It's not that bad. I was going to say, geez, if it's already going orange, then we're on super slicks, then that's a problem. Everybody goes around again on lap 8, so the NSX is at a huge disadvantage here. It's going to have to make now, you know, lap 9, you're looking at a 6, at basically a 6 stop. Which would be two fewer than the, NSX. And a pit stop is going to cost you about 20 to 25 seconds, depending on the track, so... Not the greatest suggestion ever. But if that's what they're gonna do, then... Like I said, like, if I pit this lap, I'm already down to a 5-stop race. Like, I'm 3 stops less than what that NSX is going to have to make. Which basically means that's a minute saved. At bare minimum, 1 minute saved. That's over half a lap. I mean, pretty crazy. The Supra goes around again, 54 seconds back. So it's going to go at least 10 laps on its tires. Granted, I think that next dot that just crossed our finish is the NSX. So it is running down the Supra fast. But it also has to pit 4 laps, so... For all the good it's doing you. You might get back to second on the racetrack, but... He'll be in shortly thereafter. Now nearing a full minute. The two anchoring skylines are only up just really heading toward the end of sector 2, so I mean. Oop. So try to be careful not to cut that left-hand kink, but it's hard to do sometimes. Especially to do 60 times in a row, so... Oh, car... Probably still gained time doing that. Lead now just over 1 minute at the line. Skylines out of the corner, out of the last corner. Will any of them head for pit road? The car in fourth doesn't. Fifth and sixth don't either. Man, that NSX made a horrible call. Whatever pit strategy they're on, whatever tire they're running. I mean, he's catching second play. He's catching the Supra, but... What good is that going to do you when, by the time you catch and pass the Supra, you have to pit, so... Knock the wall down at the end of Sector 2 and still got a 51.8 out of it. That's still faster than what the Supra's running, so I mean... Lap 12, we now have a 4-stop race in play here. So now half as many pit stops as I expect that the NSX is going to have to make. That's a solid probably 90 seconds. Now we're nearing a full lap saved. almost knocked the wall down. That would have been rude. Minute 5 second lead at the line. So we, despite that being a 151.8, I still gained over 5 seconds. Or nearly, give or take. Granted, the NSX has caught back up. Gained 3 seconds in Sector 1, somehow. Don't know how I made 3 seconds up on it. Like, obviously, it's on pretty worn tires itself at this point. I think the rest of us must all be on the Super Slicks at this point. I mean, there's no way they'd go that far. I mean, I can tell my fronts are starting to go orange now, like, legit, so. And I still put up a 48.8, so, I mean. I have, you know, the advantage of the wheels, that rear wheel spin is actually helping keep the car from pushing like it would with worn front tires. I can hear those skylines at the back of the field. On the road, me, come on. Definitely go 15 laps. I would not push any further than that. Yeah, the NSX has now made up the difference it gave up on that pit stop. We also were 9 seconds quicker than the Supra that lap, so I mean, or 8.5 or something like that. Regardless, we were way faster. The Supra going around again, like that's pretty wild. It does look like the NSX is now, yeah, handily taken second. That Supra has dropped off dramatically. All three of the Skylines still going around. So it looks like we're all eyeing around 15 seconds. Wow, I was only 2/10 off my best lap that lap. I'm on 13 lap old tires, and I ran within 2/10 of my best lap. Like I said, I'm definitely not pushing that hard. I could probably run a 45 or a 44 if I really wanted. Excuse me. Two of the Skylines lapped on the first fuel stint. Oh, okay, yeah. She pushed that time. Okay, well, you can have your lap back. I'll take that back in a minute. Now I think the fronts are starting to lose grip. Almost all at once. I'm starting to feel it kind of push in the corner. To actually trigger that rear traction, that loss of rear traction, just to get it to turn. So, okay, lap 14, so the NSX should be in. No, it isn't. But the Supra has finally cracked 13 laps. Okay, so what's the NSX doing then? Was 7, now it's going at least 8. Or, sorry, no, now it's on lap 14. What am I talking about? That was 13. It'd be in this time by. We'll be in next time by. As I had planned. I got the Pennzoil Nismo Skyline, which we're going to lap entering turn 1. The Supra got out ahead of us, so it just stays on the lead lap. It should. Well, we'll see. We'll see how much faster it is on cold tires now. Not much, because we lapped it anyway. Okay, cool. Yeah, oh yeah, my left front is gone. So. But really, I mean, up and down the stack, I mean, like I said, 13 laps in to run a lap within 2/10 of my best. Both means that I'm late, you know, leaving time on the table, but I'm also, also putting up consistent numbers here. NSX is heading for the last corner. It should be in this time by, completing its 14th lap. It's sticking to that short pit strategy. Push harder over shorter stints. Yep, it's in. So the NSX in for its second stop. We're coming in for our first. We know the Supra's going to get its lap back. And the three Skylines have not yet come in. So they're on the same tires that I'm on, basically. Here we come to pit road. Thankfully, this game, no need to worry about pit road speed limits. The car game will take care of itself. So we're in. The Nismo's staying out again. Granted, it was a lap down, so it's now on lap 15. All three of the Skylines. So the Skylines are going at least a three stop. So we head out to start our second stint. Skylines are going at least 15. I can't see them going further than that unless their tire wear is really, really good. They have, you know, in order to save another stop, they got to get all the way to lap 20. Lap 20 is the point of a two-stop race. Although it would perhaps explain why they're running so slow if it's a tire-saving strat, but I mean. We are on pace to complete this race in under 2 hours, as I suspected. Completion of lap 15, we were in under a half hour, so that's good. Interval at the line, 1:47, so obviously that will come down. At Sector 1, we'll really see where we're at when the NSX hits Sector 1. We're about to. The Skylines are going around again. 1.5 minutes. Okay, well, now I'm confuzzled. Now I'm really confuzzled. Alright, well, that was just rude. Come on. Yield to the leader. Blue flags. Come on. So they, you know, they're on a three-stop race anytime between now and lap 20. So I mean, you're better served to pit when the window opens, as opposed to drag it out on worn tires. Thank you. 31.0 at the line. That is the interval. Alright. I'm starting to wonder if the skylines are glitched or something, because that's 16 laps now, and they have not come in. So either they've got God-tier wear, or I feel like they should have been in by now. I mean, they're slow as molasses, so I mean, it doesn't really matter. They're already a lap down. They could go the whole race without pitting, I'd still win. So I would just be incredibly, astonished if they make it to lap 20 and are trying the two stop. In our sights. Up a 46.4 to knock a solid second off our best lap. And the skylines all stay out again. They're on 17 laps now. That would be mighty impressive if they could stretch their tires that far. For all the good it's doing them, they're going to finish 4th, 5th, and 6th anyway, but... That notwithstanding, might catch the NSX before it makes its next stop, too. I mean, we're not that far behind. Lead now 1:41, and we're running 40. That's 2:46s in a row for us, so I mean. Alright, the NSX. Okay, the Skylines are coming around to complete lap 18, so. They're staying out again. Mighty impressive, I gotta say. And the NSX has definitely dropped off in pace. Its tires are going away pretty quick. Thank you. simmer down a bit here because I'm, the faster lap times I put up, obviously, the harder I'm working those tires, and I really do want them to get to lap 30. Should get the NSX this time going into turn one, or by actually get him on the front stretch. So that should seal it because by the between now and the time I pit, it's got to pit two more times. It'll be coming in lap after next. Well, remember I'm a lap ahead now, so it'll be coming in a lap after next. And then again, seven laps after that. Of course, now the field has been put a lap down, we'll no longer get those cheeky updates as to how far ahead we are, because who cares? We've lapped them. Yeah, I guess the Skylines are going for 20 laps. That's... if they go past 20, then they're definitely glitched. Because the only other option then is a one-stop, and that means they have to go to lap 30 without pitting. Basically double stinting their tires, and I mean that would be pretty wild. That's the kind of thing you do when you know you're gonna just destroy a field like this and you're just like, yeah, hell with it, I'll just do it without pitting. And then you're running like, by the time you know all four tires are red, you're running like 6 seconds a lap off the pace, but you're still dominating the race, so who cares? It's like, but that's just silly. We don't want to do that. .472 that lap. 9 laps away from our next stop. The NSX. Right, it's now on lap 21, so they'll be in this time by. I believe the Supra will be in next time as well. Lap after next. The Supra goes to 24, I think. Give or take. Alright, let's see. If the Skylines don't pit this time, there's something wrong. There's no way they're going for the one stop. Yeah, no, they're all staying out. So the Skylines have now gone 20 laps into this race without making a pit stop. So the only other viable strategy left is one stop, and that means they're going to lap 30. They pit any time before lap 30, and they have to pit again. So either they're broken and just aren't going to pit ever, Or I want to know what Nissan makes their tires, you know, the tires they mount out of. I want someone to go down to those Skyline garages. I want their tires inspected. NSX is in. That's his third stop. I believe the Supra is going to jump it. Well, the Supra's definitely going to jump it. Remember, the Supra has to pit again shortly as well. I think on its 24th lap. Or it's only starting lap 22, so it's about... it's got to do three more before it comes in. If I'm correct. Or did it go 11? I can't remember. Whatever it went, it's either in this time or in two or three laps. Skylines go around again. We're now about halfway through our tire stint. Tire's still looking good. Even though we've really been averaging some better times this second run. Seven laps to go. Shockingly well, staying within track limits, all things considered. Avoiding, you know, only hit a couple of walls so far. I've really only marginally cut a couple of corners, nothing crazy. Oh, here we go. So the Nismo's in at lap 22. The other two are staying out. Pennzoil Nismo can only go 22, so now its strategy looks stupid because that's still a three-stop race. Or no, sorry, that's still a two-stop. I mean, 22:44. I mean, I suppose it does give your third stint. You can push your third stint a little harder. But I mean, time lost running those extra four laps, those two extra laps in the first two stints, really worth it? And the question is, what about the other two? Those other two Skylines that didn't come in that lap. I thought those three of them would have come in all together, but basically being the same car, more or less. While the NSX and the Supra are right tight together here. The NSX has caught back up, and the Supra still has to make its second stop, which should be this lap, lap 20. It's on its 24th lap. Granted, it only has to go about three laps before it can maybe get the overcut on the NSX, because it has to. The NSX has got to pit in four laps. Two Skylines still stayed out. So they've done 24 laps now. Or no, sorry, 23 laps now. I don't get it. We're five laps away from our next stop. Left front starting to show orange. So take her easy. I coming up on the poor Penzoil Nismo, about to go two laps down, less than halfway into this race. Granted, if it can stay close, it'll get one of its laps back when I pit four laps, but I mean... That to be the case. It has to stay within about 15 to 20 seconds of me. Turn to those two skylines ahead of me, just ahead of me, coming through the final corner. Lap 24, are they coming in? No, they're not. They're on some kind of pro gamer play, but I don't think it's gonna, you know, doesn't work when you're hella slow, but down a little too much there, and then the car's just like, yeah, all the turning. Why not? Ooh, ooh, easy, cowboy. Oh, okay, that was kind of, okay, I may have contributed to that poor Calsonic skyline getting stuffed into the tire barriers there. Coming out of the tunnel hairpin, that's what you get for being too slow. Just stay out of my way. Like, it's not that hard. Blue flag, yield to back, you know, back markers must yield to the leaders. Now the Zexel. There it goes, two laps down. Well, what are you gonna do now? On lap 25, are they going to go a 50, a 25, 50, 60 run? 25, 25, 10? Nope. Still going. He's still going. They're going. I think they are legitimately going for the one stop. Legitimately going for the one stop. If they don't pit at lap 30, then they're probably going the entire race because there's something, you know, utterly wrong with their pit RNG or whatever the fuck. Supra is in. That would be a completion of lap 26. So yeah, 13 laps a run. It's a bit of an odd play there. I mean, it's way behind the NSX, even though the NSX has made, at this point, one extra stop than it. So Super. So, the NSX's strategy might actually get a second place. Even if the Supra only needs, half as many stops. Supra's basically like a full timing sector ahead. Actually, more than a timing sector ahead. Car's on worn tires, Amp. You can't do that. Cannot go full steam up that hill. Oh, you can't do that. And a half away from halfway. Feels like already. I know it's been 52 and a half minutes into this race. It does not feel like it's been that long. They say time flies when you're having fun. And I guess that's the case in this particular situation. But fronts have definitely clipped. I can feel the car again, just like last run. Car's beginning to push through the corner, and I kind of need that rear wheel spin to help me out. This time by. Just about caught the soup. But we won't catch the soup, not on this, at least not on this fuel run, because this tire run, because we'll catch it probably during the next one. Oh yeah, she's got the plow going. The NSX is in for its fourth stop. End of lap 28, just like I figured. Tires have had enough of this. Of this shenanigan. So we'll head for the pits. Take our second stop. We will cross the line for halfway. Right there. 55 minutes, so looking at about an hour 50 minute race, looks like. Roughly 91 miles on our trip count, on our odometer. Now the Zexel's in. Lap 20, and the Calson, so lap 27. End of 27. So there, okay, that is a really weird. Because if the AI were actually smart enough to know that, okay, well, that means I can do a six-lap stint at the end and push hard, and just push super hard for it, and it's like, okay, cool, but then you've already wasted so much time, and literal time on the racetrack, babying your tires for 27 laps. You really think you're going to gain that time back on a six-lap sprint? unless they've recalculated and realized, okay, we're two laps down. We'll probably be four by the end of the race. That would be 56. So they'd be close to making it off that stuff. If they gamble on being four laps down by the end of the race, and I know the AI aren't that smart, but if they could conceivably make it a one stop just by factoring in the number of times they're being lapped. I don't think that's going to be the case. Enough. I was trying to keep my right side tires on the rumble strip, if nothing else. Kind of worked, I guess. Kind of stabilized the car, but nothing didn't really mean to pop the inside wall there. But it kind of worked. Super, I'm coming back up on here a little bit. I should be catching within the next lap or so. That's the Super. The NSX must be coming out of turn one now. That puts the two Skylines going through the S's, and that puts the Pennzoil one heading through Sector 3 now, or Sector 4, I should say. Thank you. There's the soup. Although we had just about caught it when we came to pit road. So we made up that gap and then some. Just three, a little over 3.5 laps. There, through the S curve, through the S, yeah, the S pin as I call it, S turn hairpins. But we do put it 2 laps down. It's become a start lap 35. That means that the NSX is working lap 34 as we speak. Which means it's in. Not this time by, but the next time by, anyway, for its 5th stop already. I mean, it's the strat is working. It is in 2nd by a fair bit. It's bar none the second fastest car on the track. It's, you know, only about the length of Sector 3 behind the, 2 skylines in the back, so. So the game is afoot, as it were. Alright, 25 laps to go. 10 laps to our final pit stop. I didn't even notice, but lap 34, we did set our best lap of the race, a 45.5. So we knocked another, almost a second off that previous best lap. Also, we're noticing if you look at the cumulative race timer, we're still counting in minutes, even though we're now north of an hour. Because I couldn't be bothered to add a spot for hours, I guess. It's just become a bit annoying when you get to, like, Tokyo and Monaco, when those races go north of 2.5 hours, and you're sitting there thinking, how many minutes has this race been so far? Oh, this race has been 195 minutes. That's 2 hours and 15 minutes, you know. But fair enough. There's the NSX. Oh, he's not happy about getting lapped again. second best car on the track despite making more pit stops than everybody else. Two laps down. Should be pitting this time by, so it's going to lose even more ground. We've got a... In fact, actually, we're already catching the skylines again, so... We've got the skylines in sight. To put them all three laps down. There goes the NSX, as I figured it would, for its now fifth pit stop. As we lap the Calsonic for the third time. Somewhere the execs at Nissan are having a meltdown about an American car putting the whooping to all this Japanese muscle. But then I'm sure they... then they remember, oh yeah, this isn't actually the Japanese Touring Car Championship, and therefore... But in any event, there's the Zexel. Actually, the Nismo has gotten a big gap out there. A little bit of that suck from the draft. There's the entire distance from the first hairpin to the second to catch the Pennzoil skyline, but. To catch it. It's already two laps down. How much more do we need? The hour and 10-minute mark. We are also approaching two-third distance. Distance elapsed now. According to the odometer, I'm assuming the odometer's in miles. Because this is a 300-kilometer race, and I've only gone 118 kilometers. By my calculation, we should not be near two-thirds distance, so that makes sense. I'm sure if I changed my speedometer to kilometers per hour, it would tweak the odometer as well, but... exiting the S-pin, it just wants to come around with you and do all kinds of shenanigans. Alright. 40 laps in the books, 20 laps to go, 5 laps to our final pit stop. Just north of an hour and 13 minutes. But it worked, I guess. We've caught the Pennzoil Nismo GTR. Oh, it took a shot at me. It took a swing at me. Trying to spin me out. That was rude. Listen, not my fault your car's 3 laps down. Okay, it kind of is my fault, but, you know, it's not my fault that, that Nismo couldn't make you a decent car for this race. I mean, come on. It was that magic oil change, I'm telling you. Nobody check my oil after this race. Supra's in. It's his third stop, I believe. Should be. Yeah, if it's 3 laps, that'd be, yeah, lap 39. Yeah, that makes sense. Supra's doing 13 lap stints. 3 more laps to get in ourselves. Fronts have plateaued. Front tires are saying no mas. I still gotta get 2 more laps out of them. Man, we just keep firing off 48s, so I mean. Problem now is you're gonna have this pushy loose condition. The 1 hour and 20 minute mark. Making pretty good time. We'll definitely get in under an hour. Well, definitely well under 2 hours. Not quite sure if we'll get in under an hour 50. Then. Next time by is 3/4 distance. I mean, we keep averaging under a minute. Keep running sub 150s for the rest of this race. You know, notwithstanding our in and out laps, then we might pull this under a 150. We'll see. This is our in lap, so we do have to kind of push as best we can with our fronts all wore out. Advantage of the rear wheel spin and they get some drift doing going here. It's definitely oversteering under throttle, so. Oversteering on the gas is good. That means now I gotta basically check it up, the NSX in again for its 6th stop. So it's completing lap 42 right now. probably be north of 150 if I was on track for it. But anyway, to pit road for our final stop. Them four tires, invisible crew that I can't see. We are gone. We're good to the finish. But to be entirely honest, now I feel like seeing how much. We're well over 2.5 laps up on the field. I'm kind of interested to see how low I can push that best lap now. So I might actually split these last 15 laps into maybe 2 or 3 stints and just try to, push hard and see if we can maybe knock a couple more seconds off that time. So I will probably come in again at about lap 54, so 53 or 54. Put 4 tires on again and see if we can't. Oh, not by doing that, we're not. The rumble strip was not happy. It's fine to drift. Don't drift on the rumble strips, that's all. Haul the mail, 14 laps to go. That was a gnarly cut there, didn't mean to do that. She's gone. Okay. This car does not like being pushed hard, evidently. The rear tires still aren't up to temp yet, so fair enough, I guess. Try this lap then. Oil Nismo's in for its second stop. Oh, is lap 44, which makes sense. Hot one here. I don't know if it's going to be a 45.5, but and I don't think it will be. We're getting back up there. We're now down, back down to the 46s, so now trying to ramp it up a little, step it up a little bit. It doesn't like to be stepped up. It's maybe one of those cars where you want to go slower to go faster, I guess. Oh, the replay is probably too long now, maybe. I don't know. Don't know what that means. Could be an emulator thingy, too. So, I don't know. And see, I'm trying to push hard, and I'm only getting 46 to 47, so maybe. Step it back toward more of a conservative approach in the slower corners. Let's see if that makes any difference. Seven across the bridge. Not a great exit from the F pin, though, so I think that probably just been right where I was, right where all these other laps have been. A 46. 46.3. That's not bad. We're going to catch catch the super in a really awkward spot. That's going to force me to check going through here. But the soup is now three laps down. Everybody else is all clumped up in sector three right now. That was awful. All right. That was a horrendously bad corner. Sex having to pick through those skylines, or has picked through those skylines. I ran that 45.5, I have no idea. Yeah, mystery for the ages at this point, looks like. Three for the ages, I guess. And the NSX in again. That's pit stop number 7, I believe. Has one more to do, and we'll put it three laps down. Well, it's on pit road. And we're about to catch the skylines again to put them four down. Second. Okay, we're fine. Felt a little spike there. I thought maybe my internet had crapped the bed again. I'd be like, which would be very, very awkward to then have like hour and a half stream followed by a 6-minute video that shows the final, well, not 6 minutes, like a 10-minute video that shows the finish of the race. That would just be silly. Very silly, actually. 7 laps to go. We put the 3 Skylines now 4 laps down. And with the NSX and the Soup way back on the front straightaway, there's no way we're going to no possible chance of us catching them again, I don't think. Looks like that's how the field will pan out. Six to go. You just have to accept the fact that you are going to get sent way, way, way wider than you want to do, and you just live with that fact. And we hit 1 hour, 40 minutes. 100-minute mark. This is really going to be, can we finish the rest of this race within the next 10 minutes? Get it in under an hour 50. Laps to go. We'll say with how quickly that first half went, the second half has kind of dragged a bit. Well, I will not lie, but said, Supra back in. That is its fourth stop. Lap 52, yeah, that makes sense. Sector timers are starting to lag a little bit. Kind of desyncing a little little tiny bit. Four laps to go. 7 minutes and 15 seconds to do it in. Pretty close. Really, just I'm saying that more as a personal goal, not so much as a. I just want to get, I would like to average less than a minute 50 a lap. Starting to lose front grip. Three to go. 5.5 minutes to get it in. Makes sense. 5 minutes to 300 seconds. So I have to average about 100 seconds a lap. Yeah, I can't do it. It's a minute 40. If I'm coming to two to go this time, I have to be there. Going away. Just over the minute 50 mark. If I hadn't spun myself trying to push so hard, 3 minutes and 40 seconds to do two laps. Well, wait a minute, no. It's a minute 50 a lap. Yeah, as long as I stay above a minute 50 a lap. As long as I stay above a minute 50 a lap. Below a minute 50 a lap these last two laps, we're good. Not by much, but we're good. Thank you. Okay, so we gotta run about that lap or better. My front tire is completely shot. There it went. Yeah. Well, we're not finishing this race in under a minute in under an hour 50 then. Yeah, the fronts are gone. I pushed it way too hard those first five laps of that run. I should have if I backed her up, I would have run just as fast and probably saved the tires better. Yeah, well. And the poor NSX. Somebody tell the NSX the leader's on the last lap. He doesn't have to do that. That would be pit stop number 8. Yeah, I mean, the car's done. If I was Lewis Hamilton, I'd be, tires are gone. Tires are gone. Yeah, well, I'll just bring her home. Not even close to anybody on the track. Question is, did the NSX's strategy end up working? All those extra pit stops compared to the Supra, did it hang on for second? Or has the Supra taken second place on the podium? We score the win at Grand Valley. 1 minute, 1 hour, 50 minutes, 6.819 seconds. We will wait for the AI to complete their final laps. Unlike GTs 1 and 2, the race for them does actually end at the end of this lap. We don't have to wait for them to actually complete the full 60 lap distance, because it will officially score them as laps down. So, the NSX, 4 more stops than the Supra, and yet still hold on for second. And the Nismo GTR takes 4th, with the Zexel and Calsonic 5th and 6th. And the NSX is that was the Nismo in, 4 laps down in 4th. Next through is the NSX at 3 laps down in 2nd. 2 cars coming in together. The Skylines are pitting, despite the fact they're coming to the checkered flag. Oh, well, they're 5th and 6th anyway. Who the hell cares? Might come to where their pit boxes are. Nope, not really. The Zexel's box was after the start finish line. The Calsonics was before it. And then the Supra in 3rd place, 3 laps down, and the Sky. There you go. Yeah, it is what it is. We dominated them. We take 400,000 credits. We're not watching all that again. All right, prize car time. 4 possible choices. What's it gonna be? Come on, open wheel, open wheel. Yes, we got a Formula GT car. Yes, we need one of those. Very nice. That looks like one of the old McLarens of the day. Let's take a quick little gander at this bad boy here. We have the FO90S, which is one of Ayrton Senna's rides. 690 horsepower stock, 312,500 credits value. I believe there's no tuning at all for this, but we'll check anyway. No tuning at all. In fact, there's so little tuning, the only tires you're allowed to have on this thing are the medium racing tires, which means, Formula GT is going to be fun. I can't wait to have to pit every 6 laps. That's going to be great. But, we'll need that for the Formula GT Championship at the very end of the festivities. Notice we're down to 986 horsepower because of the oil being pretty well used up. But if I complete the oil change and polish the car down after it's hard racing, does it put it back to the 1032? Yeah, sure does. Very nice. All right. That will put us 57.2%, although it's really higher because remember arcade mode, technically I got to redo that again. I am going to save that because I really don't want to rerun that. So yeah, bit of a shorter stream, not really quite 2 hours, but we really don't have time for anything else because next will be the Seattle 100 mile race. And I'm hoping time will permit so that we can do Super Speedway 150 miles in the same stream. Those two we'll do together. Seattle pays $150,000 to win. Super Speedway pays $200,000. And we'll hopefully get a couple of more really good vehicles for that. And we'll go from there. So, with that being said, thank you for watching. If you're seeing this on YouTube, hit the link in the description. Follow me on Twitch. Turn on notifications. Hopefully you don't miss a stream. If you're watching this on Twitch, thanks for hanging out tonight. Watching me drive around Grand Valley next time, whenever that is. We got hopefully two more on the docket. So thanks for hanging out. We'll see y'all in the next one. Later!